Welcome from Bailey Excavating, sponsoring Michigan's Military Heritage Museum, Jacob Bailey, and from the museum, Kevin Garish. Guys, good to see you both. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having us.
Wow, what a great year from Michigan Military Heritage Museum, Kevin. We've had a lot of cool things happen this year.
Yeah, it's been quite a whirlwind year. A lot of fun stuff.
And the Bailey family, you've adopted this museum and been very supportive and financially, but personally, you guys, I think you have taken quite an interest in military history.
Oh yeah, yep. I've always loved military history since I was a kid. I used to joke that when I was a kid, all my friends were watching cartoons, and I was watching the History Channel. But it's been fun being involved with the museum. You know, it's something I find interesting. So it's more of a enjoyment to be involved than any type of hassle or anything like that. So
yeah, what a treasure to have this here in our community and right at a very historic spot. You are at a significant Civil War historical location.
Yep, right on the site of Camp Blair, 1864 to 1866.
And everything that this community has retained from Camp Blair, you have it in your museum.
A lot of it, yeah. There's always something that's probably in somebody's attic somewhere that we don't know about, but resurfacing or excavating a lot of the parking lot, we found a lot of artifacts, a couple of little roller buckles, a mallet head that's stamped U.S. on it.
Yeah, you were just digging out an excavation out in your parking lot.
Yeah. Yep.
All right, we got an event coming up. A concert?
Yes, Saturday, July 20th, we're going to have Rock for Warriors at the museum. It's going to be BFT's The Zoo, a good friend of ours, Brian Thomas, from this band here, Halloween, Detroit's Halloween.
Oh my
gosh. You may remember him. He's a lead singer, and so he's got some other projects, and the Scorpions tribute band is one of his, and so he's going to be playing some other songs, not just Scorpions. And then we're also going to have the Ruiners, Detroit rockabilly punk band, great band, another band that's been a longtime friend of ours.
What is it about heavy metal and military history? Because it seems like a lot of heavy metal bands are into military history.
You know, I'm not sure, but it works for me. That's two of my favorite things, music and military history. So I don't know what it is. I can't explain it, but it works for me.
Jacob, do you know all the Scorpions hits?
I know a couple. Nope, that band's pretty cool. We got to meet the singer and go to a Judas Priest concert with him earlier in the summer, and see Sabaton as well, who's been involved with the museum before, so that was cool. I got to meet those guys, and it's going to be a good show on Saturday.
Nice. Yeah, Sabaton, they were here, a couple years ago?
No, back in April?
Oh, yeah. But I guess it's been twice they've been here?
Been here several times. Yeah, they were here October of 2023. We've been doing stuff with them since 2016, 2017-ish.
Awesome.
And they're kind of what you were talking about, too. They're, from Europe, but they're heavily interested in World War I, World War II history. They do a lot of educational, songs, videos, short movies, that kind of stuff. So it ties in with the military side of things.
Yeah, I think the community got to know them a little bit more and were exposed to their music when they were here. Now, how does this concert work? Because I'm thinking about the footprint you have on Wisner Street. Where do people park? Where's the stage, the setup? How's it all going to happen?
So the stage is going to be set up in our parking lot. Long ways, so, and then we're going to have people, it's going to be cordoned off, people will enter. We're going to have a food truck, Bibles and Burgers food truck, and soft drinks available. It's free admission, but we do ask that you make a donation right now. We're doing a fundraiser for the family of William Butler, the Hillsdale Sheriff's Deputy who was killed in the line of duty. On any regular day at the museum, when you come in, if you round up your admission price, all extra proceeds after your price of admission will go towards the family of Deputy Butler.
Oh, awesome.
And same thing with the concert. It's free to come, but we just ask that you make a donation of any sort to the family of Butler, and we'll have buckets and stuff set up for that.
Awesome. What time does the show start?
Starts at 6 p.m.
So people could come early, tour the museum.
Absolutely, yeah. Yep.
How much time do you think it takes a first-time visitor to get through the museum?
Oh, that's a good question for you, because I'm there every day.
Yeah. It depends on how in-depth you want to go. I mean, if you want to kind of make your way through and, you know, just get eyes on everything, you know, maybe an hour or so. But if you want to stop and read every display, and if there's a, you know, a volunteer there, each of the volunteers know, you know, different things about different topics. So every time you go, you get a different experience. And I mean, if you do that, it could be hours in there. And
yeah, there's a lot. Last time I was there was on Free Museum Day, and you had a really nice turnout. And there were so many people from Jackson, and the line I heard the most was, I had no idea this was here. But you do get people from all over.
Absolutely, all over the world.
And they make this is a destination trip to come to Jackson to see this museum. It's awesome. And it's right here. What are the days and hours you guys are typically open, Kevin?
So we're open Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays, 11 to 5. And then we're also open on Sundays from noon to 4.
And you've been a big part of this museum in the last year or so. Mm-hmm. And you'll often see the Bailey family participating as volunteers. I think I saw you, were you cooking hot dogs on Jackson County Museum Day?
Yep, we had one of our friends was there with us. He was cooking hot dogs for the event, and we were doing the archaeological dig as well, so had a lot going on that day, and found some cool artifacts that we were able to trace back to Camp Blair, so that was pretty
awesome.
Exciting.
Jacob, did you bring something with you today?
I did. My dad wanted me to give this to you.
Oh,
he
awesome.
Said it's been a while since he's brought you one.
Yes, your dad stops by every week, and he brings a donation from the Donation Bakery, which we appreciate very much.
I understand you're a baker now.
Yes, I am. Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe I should bring you guys some bread.
There you go. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still working up to. I can't produce the quantity that Donation is able to do. All right. Once again, thank you. Thanks, John. Once again, the concert. The whole event happening this Saturday. Go online now, get your ticket, make a donation.
Yep. If you can't make it and you want to make a donation, our PayPal is mmhminfo@gmail.com. And just put in the memo note for Butler family if you'd like to make that donation. And also would like to make a big shout out to our sponsor, County National Bank. Just came through the other day for it, and really
awesome.
Grateful for it.
Great. Well, nice to have you both here today. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
And we'll see you Saturday at Michigan Military Heritage Museum. Thanks to Kevin Garish and from Bailey Excavating, Jacob Bailey. Well, that's it.